Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy. I've been wanting to do a video talking about the BBS as a whole and where could it go, and then the anime came back, and then I kind of felt it was pointless because there you go, they have content. And obviously there was people talking about the idea or concept about the Fazzy Blood War arc expiring in the game by March 21st or 31st of 2021, to which people now believe is when they're going to announce the anime, or sorry, when they're going to announce like a PV or like a release date or the studio, etc, etc. So I kind of want to talk about what annoys me about this game, personally speaking. I saw Tory Crunch's video and I'm kind of rubbing it off him, so shout out to him, and if you go check out his video on it, he kind of delved more into the idea about the banners, about how there's too many, which I do agree on. I do think there is too many, because back in the day, there used to be like your summons tickets, your premium banners, and then whatever the hyped banner was at that specific set time. But I'm not going to be talking so much about that, so to say. I'm just going to be talking about the overall game and why I personally don't like it anymore and why I think it will probably fail for a, not right now, but in the long term, I think it's going to go downhill. And I think there's a bit of psychology in regards to, I generally believe when this got announced, when this game got announced, people used this game as like a hole to fill during the anime's, you know, non-existence. You know, it was there, people liked the concept art, people liked following the story. They generally believe that supporting the game would bring the anime back, to which I do believe to a high degree that has actually happened. So I was like a big advocate and looking at the sales figures for BBS, seeing the revenue sharing and whatnot, to see if there was enough investment or money to go into the game, as well as enough to warrant Shueisha to bring back an anime, so to say. To which I strongly believe it did, because when the Blood War characters, the first 14, got announced, that was easy. When it got announced, you know, people were flocking to it. The money, I think, had doubled. The fiscal years, you can look at the fiscal sales, I think it was of 2018 to 2019. It really blew things out of the park, and I think that's what Shueisha wanted. I think that's why they had the original 14 characters to kind of have a test in the waters. A test in the waters, James. Say English correctly. And obviously, that succeeded. Hence why, obviously, they got more licensed characters. And of course, with new licensed characters and with Can't Feel Your Own World, and even with a new opening, this requires money and investment. Now, of course, is this Caleb's investment? Of course it is. But you would have to get licenses to get new voice actors, to which we obviously know, and we now know what the bigger picture was. Stuff like Yamamoto, for example, and even Soifon, because those two voice actors did, you know, unfortunately die. So I generally believe, other than the concept art and the current story that we haven't had animated yet, that's the big appeal to BBS right now, and why people continue to play, purely from a fan perspective, rather than going from outside of the box. Now, one thing that does really aggravate me, and again, this isn't burnout for me, like I haven't played in a month, granted, but I don't think I even get the ticket because I you know, it hasn't been a month yet. But the point I'm trying to make is I don't think this is burnout for me, because after playing like the Seven Deadly Sins game, my expectation for mobile games has kind of risen in terms of character models, in terms of intensity of like world environments and graphics, and you know, the stuff you can do on it, and the PvP system's good, the guild system's good, the story mode is good, the events are good, the characters changing costumes and adding weapons, that's good as well. Yes, you can add like accessories on BBS, but it goes a little bit deeper into that game without being too jarring for like new consumers. So at the moment, as it stands, I'm liking Seven Deadly Sins. Of course, feelings are bound to change, and like with any old person. But I feel like now that the anime has kind of been announced, the want or need to play this game has kind of died down, because I feel like there's an expectation now that we're going to get more mobile games and that we're going to get more console games, and there is kind of no need to promote it or, you know, play this game anymore. To which I think is a split half and half. Maybe that's just me, but I thought it would be something to bring up nonetheless. But the one thing that annoys me, not one thing, the multiple things that annoy me in this game is that, and I think with the majority of mobile games, is the orb system or the currency systems to which they give you, with the content that they have as well. It's fine if you don't want to give players that much currency. I mean, look at the BBS live streams, for example, like, oh, they gave us two singles, hype, right? for an event, for a big anniversary, you know, it's a bit mad. But the point I'm trying to make is there is too much content that Caleb expects you to play and the time they expect you to have as well. So what I mean by that is guilds were fun because you could bring your friends along and they could help you get like a certain time limit or do a certain amount of damage and whatnot, but it got very repetitive very quickly. And the fact that they actually took away the friend feature and they stuck to you doing you. And unless you had those characters that could do the strategies that you needed to do to achieve those timestamps or those damage deals, you were pretty much out of pocket on that, and you quickly saw a very toxic competitiveness between guild ranks, and it was very difficult to have a chance, if that makes sense. Now, of course, people are good because obviously they've got the characters, and you join a good guild, that's fine. Thing is, it became very mundane. Like in Seven Deadly Sins, for example, you can join the Knighthood, but you're not kind of forced to do any of the quests there. You're not forced, you know, you have your like your daily quests, just like you do with any other game, like you do on here, like you do on single player on Seven Deadly Sins, and then if you want to, you can do the daily stuff on the Knighthood. With this, it's kind of like, do the same thing three times, your best score is the best one, and you might get two orbs from it afterwards, with maybe a brush, and maybe the odd accessory here and there. It's not really warranted, to be honest with you, because I don't feel like the reward is useful for like a mundane task, for a repetitive task that you find yourself wanting to slam your head through a fucking brick wall. But let's get the guild quest out of the way, because that is something that's apparently going to be fixed, and I have to acknowledge that. So I'm very interested to see how they're gonna fix it. Why it's taking them so long to do a summoning animation, I don't know. But hey ho, there you go. I don't think it's a needed change personally, but hey, anything to keep the game feeling fresh and innovative. But it is very temporary. It will be a temporary feeling that the consumer feels a little bit like fresh to a game. The other thing is the PvP. The PvP, again, is something I believe is going to be fixed, but again, a little long and a little too late to fix it, because again, unless you have certain characters, you will be destroyed by the meta. At least within Seven Deadly Sins, there is characters which can counteract certain characters, or characters that are bought out, for example, the Galfer and the Gallard, they both counteract each other. So if you don't get the Galfer that everybody wants, because he's pretty fucking broken, at least you have a smidgen of a chance to fight back against him. In this game, for example, when Unohana came out, she was like beasting PvP for a good solid year, and I feel like K-Lab destroyed their own battle system. And again, the rewards aren't really warranting the grind, if that makes sense. And again, like, not only do you have to do the guild quest, which again takes a significant amount of time, then you have to do your PvP, which again takes a significant amount of time, and then they expect you to do the Chronicle quest then. So once you've done the Chronicle quest, which bear in mind, you don't have that many soul tickets, and Chronicle quest eats up your soul tickets, so you don't have enough to do your dailies, and then you don't have enough to do the events, then you've got to go do the Chronicle quest and like grind up on those so you can like get enough points to get, you know, some accessories or some like other items that you need. Then you've got to go and do co-op and do epic quests, which, to be honest, you could spend 5 hours on epic quests at the top tierest thing and do like 3 minute runs each time and keep killing it, and you find yourself maybe 10% to 20% of the way through maybe doing one of your little minion characters, and then you've got to upgrade it after that. And I feel like it's such a time consuming game, and they don't give you enough like soul tickets, or they don't give you enough orbs to warrant it, and it becomes very mundane, tedious, and you don't actually feel like there's a sense of progression. And then once you get like a seasonal character, for example, you're gonna bring out a swimsuit Ruka, I'm all for it, and then 2 weeks after you announce the fact that you're gonna bring out a Can't Feel Your Own World character or a Thousand Year Blood War character, and you're like, well, I want this seasonal character, but now you're going to bring out like an actual in-canon game character that I really want to play, and because it's like Can't Feel Your Own World or Thousand Year Blood War that we haven't seen animated, and they are new and they are fresh and they are like powerful, you're kind of like, well, I don't know what to do now. So you've kind of got to miss out, and then they're exclusive, which again is TorCrunch's main point of the video in a sense. And you just kind of find yourself continuously playing without a sense of like progression. You don't have time to actually settle down, to build up a team, to get accessories for a character that you really enjoy playing. And it becomes like, you don't feel a sense of accomplishment. And then let's also then talk about like how K-Lab acts as a company. Now, I quite like K-Lab, or I did. I don't really like them much anymore, but at first when K-Lab came out with the game and they started doing the live streams, there was a sense, like, I would always watch them because not only was there a sense of creativity and a sense of like foolishness that they did it felt like they were fans of the series rather than they were there just to work on it. I mean, you had Mark that was doing like the guitar fucking endings, you had the wasabi challenges, you had them actually read the comments in a playful manner. And now, because people have left, the sense of connection with the audience and the company has also just drifted. And then they're pushing these Bleach 3D mobile games, which again is not like the from the DNA from China. Like, it's not doing that well. It's not that great of a game, to be honest with you. You did the beta. I don't think it was that well received, and it isn't going to last, let's be honest. There's a lot of games like that, and you've really not done anything new. You have a bunch of IPs, which is great, but this game to me just feels so unironically hollow now. It doesn't seem like there is a need or a want to progress any further. And yes, that does attribute to the anime coming back and we don't really need it anymore. But another thing that for me personally pisses me off a lot is just the inconsistency with its own story. Now, this may not be KLab's fault, and this could be Shueisha's fault or the licensing fault. But ultimately speaking, you can't do Can't Fear Your Own World and not have the Thousand Year Blood War arc done first, because not only are you going to confuse the people that haven't even read the Thousand Year Blood War arc, but then also you put the Can't Fear Your Own World arc not even in the order of which the novels tell the story, which is also another annoyance, because like I'm reading it and I'm like, wait, is that supposed to happen this early? Is that supposed to happen now? And it's weird because it's not in order. Things that were mentioned in chapter one were mentioned like, I think like three chapters into like Can't Fear Your Own World, so it threw me off quite a large margin, right? Like the whole Hisage finding like his motorbike or buying a motorbike, and Ginjo and Tsukishima finding, like that was like later on in the story, and like that was towards the very first half of the game. Not a big issue, it's just like a pet peeve for me, but it really throws me off, especially when there's illustrations of like Bambietta fighting Rudaban in Hoikamundo, and she's still a zombie, yet in the manga she's kind of like, not in the manga, in the light novel she's kind of like still the same, like she's been revived or healed. Bambietta got dirty. It's not the point. The point is how do you guys generally feel about BBS? Because I don't feel like it's going to last that long after the Can't Fear Your Own World and the Blood War stuff has been released. At that, I think they've hit a wall, and they seriously need to revamp the guild system. They seriously need to ramp the PvP. And my god, do they need to do something with the overall banners, because they are expecting too much from the players. They're expecting, they're actually annoying the players, I would believe, with all these characters that you are bringing out, but people don't even have enough time to play with these characters because you keep bringing out more like 2 weeks after. Like, settle down, let's go back to if you're gonna do seasonal, make the banners a lot less in currency. That is my recommendation, and let the big boy banners be like the 250s, because it's not really acceptable, and it's kind of like a slap into the face to the big fans, and you're just asking for money. Yes, a business is supposed to make money, I completely agree, but the good thing about Seven Deadly Sins is that, like, obviously you have things like the coin shop and stuff, for example, so there is a sense of like there's free to playness in it. So like, if you want to spend that extra money, it's like on gear and things that you want to strategically put the money into rather than the characters themselves. So, I don't know, like, BBS has been boring, and I think there even needs to be a new game at this point after the Blood War and Can't Fear Your Own World, or there seriously needs to be a huge meta revamp in general with all the characters, and I just generally think it needs to be more friendly. That is my stance on BBS, and I probably won't be playing BBS properly until probably, like, the Burn the Witch characters come out or a new Eureka. Because, again, I played this game as a fan, and I didn't want to get too heavily invested into it, and I never really got too heavily invested into it. Video making on it isn't that fun, to be honest with you. It's like, hey, here's the news, this is what's coming out, here's me and my character analysis, or here's me doing summoning. And I think people, for the majority of the part, only give a fuck about summoning, let's be completely honest. Other than that, it's not fun to actually play. I think it's quite mundane, I think it's quite tedious, and I don't think it has replayability, besides from, like, if they stop doing banners right now, hypothetically, for like the next 3 months, would anyone actually play it? I don't know, I'm not quite sure. Maybe I'm being a bit over melodramatic about it, but I think we are past the prime of BBS now, at the current state that it's in, and I think it should change. Something should change and be more consumer friendly. Other than that, that's my opinion on it. And I don't think after Spangle comes out, please give me Spangle or Ruruka, Bunny Ruruka. I don't I have no hope for this game anymore. Like, it's good. K-Lab did wonders for it to keep it going this long, and they kept it like really good. It was at one point the expectation for a mobile game, but I think something new needs to happen now. I feel like after the Blood War and Can't Fear World, there needs to, I don't think it can last that much longer. Other than that, tell me your guys' thoughts, because like, again, BBS, I think it's kind of past its prime now, personally speaking. So, with that being said, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you like BBS? Why do you still like BBS? Do you dislike it, and why do you dislike it? And what, and most importantly, what improvements can be made, and what improvements do you want to be made? I think is the point of the discussion of a video. So, we're going to catch more focus later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, as always, people. Peace out.